and make us old, wash us and make us whole. Father God, forgive sin. Forgive us for those sins that we have committed. Forgive those who have offended us, those who have offended us and sinned against us. Forgive our children, forgive our grandchildren, forgive our husband, forgive our family members, forgive our neighbors, Father God. Forgive, Father God. Forgive those who offend us and that you have forgiven us. Forgive them too also, Father God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, and as we approach the blessed throne, Father God, remove every hindrance that would block our prayers right now. Remove it, O Lord. Remove every hindrance right now. Remove every hindrance. Every hindrance. Every hindrance that would block our prayers. That would block our prayers and our breakthroughs, our miracles, and our answers, Father God. Oh, Father God, remove every heart that we have in our heart. Every blockage in my heart. Every blockage in my soul. Every blockage from the past. I'm present, Father God, from childhood, Father God. Remove the blockage, remove the pain, remove the hate, remove the pain, Father God. Remove the desolation, Father God. Remove the depression, Father God. Every wicked slander that they have slandered our name, Father God, remove it right now. Remove the stigmatism. Remove it, Lord. Remove it, Father God. Remove every blockage. Remove every roadblock that would hinder our prayer life right now. Remove every blockage that would that will stunt our spiritual growth. Remove it right now, Father God. Remove every evil supervisor, every evil person that has tried to destroy our lives, every evil ex-husband, soul ties, ex-boyfriend, ex-fiances. Remove them present and past, Father God. Remove it right now in the name of Jesus, Father God. Those who have hurt us beautifully and maliciously, those who wrongfully use us, Father God, have persecuted us, Father God. Oh, Father God, remove it right now. Remove it, Father God. Remove every evil power standing in our way, any evil robot, every power of darkness, every power that be, every institutionalized power. Oh, Father God, we command those powers to be destroyed right now. Remove, Father God. Remove it. Destroy those satanic powers. Remove every power against my life, every power blocking our life, every power blocking my finances, every area of my life, Father God. Oh, remove every blockade, every power, every obstacle, every evil mountain blocking my path. Oh, Father God, remove it in the name of Jesus. Let it be destroyed. Evil mountains, evil fences and roadblocks, evil mountains against my life, evil mountains against my children's life, evil mountains against my husband or my wife, evil mountains, every evil mountain in my job, in my business, evil mountains, I command you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father God, destroy, beat them down to dust, destroy every evil mountain, every roadblock in my mind, my spirit, my soul, my life, remove every evil mountain, every evil roadblock, every evil power, every evil obstacle, every evil wall, every evil fence, every roadblock against my life, against my prosperity, against my prayer life, against my marriage, against my children life, my grandchildren life, every power, every sickness and disease, every sickness and disease that is trying to hold me back. Through the blood of Jesus, and by stripes I'm healed, by stripes my children are healed, and by the stripes of Jesus Christ, my grandchildren, my children, my husband, my wife, they are healed. Heal them, Lord. Heal them, Lord, from all sickness and disease. Heal them from all infirmities. Heal them, oh Lord. Send healing right now. Send healing. Heal their body, their spirit, their soul, their mind. Send healing to my life right now. Heal my life. Heal me. Heal my past. Heal my present situation. Heal me, Lord. Heal me from the circumstances that surround me. Heal me, Lord. Heal my condition. Heal me, Lord. Deliver me. Deliver me, oh Lord. Deliver me from evil roadblocks, from satanic roadblocks, from evil mouthpiece of Satan, from the wicked tongue of the witches, from the wicked Negonite. Negonite is an evil word. It means the smitings of Satan. Remove the smitings of Satan. Break the pieces of every evil arm of wickedness, every evil hand of darkness. Break the backbone of Satan right now. Break every teeth according to Psalm number 9. Psalm number 7, you said every evil teeth of the wicked, you will smite the wicked in the same cheekbone, and you will break every teeth out their mouth. Father, you say your word that you have destroyed kingdoms for us. You have destroyed kingdoms for your children. You have destroyed princesses. You have destroyed kingdoms and princesses and princes. Oh, Father God, destroy the power. Destroy them right now. Begin to destroy them, Lord. In the marine kingdom. In the kingdom of darkness. In the spiritual wickedness in high places. In the powers and the dominions that is be. In the invisible realm and in the physical realm. In the natural realm. Begin to destroy from your Lord, from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. Begin to destroy in the name of Jesus. Begin to destroy. Destroy the power that be. Destroy every power. Every power. Every power warning against me to block my path. In the name of Jesus. Break it, Lord. Break it, in the name of Jesus. Break it and release with that fire. I command you to Satan to remove your filthy hands off of my life. Remove your filthy hands off my children, off my grandchildren. Remove your filthy hands. Remove your filthy hands of darkness. Remove your evil hands. In the name of Jesus, break and release me. Break and release my life. Break and release my finances. Break and release the Satan. You are a liar. You shall not prosper. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, saith the Lord. And every tongue that rise up against you in judgment, I condemn every evil tongue, every evil word, every evil prophecy prophesied against my life. I condemn every satanic liturgy read of God against my life. I condemn every satanic oath, the mouthpiece of Satan. I condemn every satanic prophecy in Jesus' mighty name. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that rise up against thee in judgment, any evil witchcraft, wizard, root breeze, trying to call judgment against my life. Oh, Father God, backfire, every evil word of slander, gossip. Oh, yes, character assassination in the workplace, in the business, in the church, in the community. Every mouthpiece of Satan seeking slander against your name, against your children's name, against your grandchildren's name. Oh, Father God, send it back to the sender. Send it back, sevenfold. Send it back to every lie of the enemy. Send it back to the satanic priesthood. Send it back in Jesus' mighty name. I pray. I say, God can do anything, anytime, anywhere. God can do anything. He is Lord. This is a day of deliverance. Father God, deliver me from the power of darkness. Deliver me from evil roadblocks and satanic mountains. Deliver me, Lord. Deliver my life. Deliver me, Father God. Deliver my children. Deliver my wife. Deliver my husband. Deliver me. Deliver my God. Deliver me, Lord. Deliver my life, my body, my spirit, and my soul. Deliver my mind from mind control, from satanic prophets and satanic preachers and satanic bishops, from mind control and manipulation. Deliver me, Lord. Break and release my man, Lord. Break and release my spirit. Break and release me from all past satanic prophecies. Break and release me from the power of the occult, from the power of the witchcraft, from the power of the psychic hotline. Break and release my life. Break and release me from power card reading. Break and release me, Lord. Break and release me from the power of evil. Break and release me from familiar spirits. Break and release me, Lord, from satanic generational curses and generational oaths and ancestral covenants. Break and release me from satanic ancestral covenants. Break and release me from satanic oaths. Break and release me from any cultic like I ever joined. Break and release my life. Break and release my soul. Break and release my soul. Break and release me, O Lord. Break and release me. Oh, Lord, avenge us. Oh, God, avenge us. Oh, God, avenge us. Arise. And let my enemies be scattered. Let my enemies be scattered. Let my enemies be scattered. Scatter my enemies, O Lord. Scatter them into desolation. Scatter them down into the pit. Physical enemies. Spiritual enemies. Demon enemies. Enemies of my job. Enemies of my business. Enemies of my marriage. Enemies of my finances. Enemies of my health. Every enemy of my soul, my spirit, enemies of my children and my grandchildren, enemy of my husband, enemies of my wife, enemies of my fiance. Oh, Father God, scatter them. God of vengeance. God, you say vengeance belongs to thee and you will repay. Repay my my enemies. I recall any cause that persecuted me, that lied against me. Repent the evil mountains. Repent the life of the enemy. Circle back, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Circle back and bring around every lie of the enemy. Every friend, go back. It's time for my enemies to pay. Pay my time. Pay my man, pay back, oh Lord. You said we wrestle not against flesh and blood, Lord. You said in the word that we cannot fight them in the flesh and blood. That stick and stone cannot do it. Fist and kicking cannot do it. But we're fighting them in the spiritual realm. Because your words say, Father God, that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. But mighty through God to the pulling down of the stronghold. We pull it down. We pull it down in the roadblock. Pull it down into the pit. Reach up and pull it down. Reach up and pull it down like a light seat. Pull it down. Pull down in the stronghold. Pull down in the weapon of the enemy. Pull down every slant of it. Pull it down in the pit of it. Pull down in the pit. Pull down in the pit. All my enemies. Lord of vengeance. Oh Lord of vengeance. Arise and let my enemies escape. Beat my foes down. Beat my foes down. Beat my enemies down. Beat them with untempered mortar. Beat them down, Lord, with your mighty hand of righteousness. Smash my enemies to pieces and beat them down to dust. Dust to dust and ashes to ashes. I say dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Dust to dust, ashes to ashes. For those enemies who wanted you to die, who went to the voodoo priest, took my name, I wanted me to die. Slander my name. I wanted me to die. Oh, Father God, dust to dust, ashes to ashes to them. Get them dust to dust. Turn them into dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Turn them into dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Let my enemies fall. Let the ripple effect of the download. Let them fall. Let them fall in the same grave that they dug for me, oh Lord. Let my enemies fall in the same pit that they dug for me. False prophets, false teachers, false pastors, false bishops, voodoo priests, psychic hotlines, human demons, principalities and powers, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness and happy, clinical witches and root doctors, clinical nurses of witchcraft, clinical doctors and chemistry of the enemy, evil biological weapons of warfare, all Father God in the name of Jesus, begin to destroy, burn, burn, burn them to ashes, Lord, burn them, Lord, burn them from the north, burn them from the south, burn them from the east, burn them, burn them, Lord, burn them to ashes, burn them from the west, burn them, Lord, burn my enemies up, burn them to ashes, burn them to the plan, burn them to ashes, Lord, burn them to the plan they have against my life, my spirit, and my soul, burn them to ashes in Jesus' mighty name. There is a weapon of warfare that they fashion against me, turn back against them. Let my enemies begin to destroy themselves right now. Begin to destroy themselves. Come on, Father God. Come on, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let my enemies begin to destroy themselves. Let them begin to destroy themselves. No, let them begin to. Let the angel of the Lord, God, command them and turn them around. Blind for my enemies so they can begin to destroy themselves. Destroy themselves. Let my enemies destroy themselves. Destroy themselves. Destroy. Raise war against my enemies. Oh, yes, in the name of Jesus Christ. Raise war, Lord. Raise war against my enemies. Raise war against my enemies. Let them begin to destroy themselves. Destroy themselves. Destroy themselves. Destroy themselves. Let them be consumed. Let them be consumed now. All on. Let them receive a double portion of their own poison. Let them feel poison. Let them try to poison me with. Let them feel poison. Return unto them. Let them receive a double portion of their compassion. Let them receive a double portion of their own spell. Backfire. Backfire. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Oh, let every satanic weapon of warfare, let every satanic weapon of warfare go back to the fender. 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 In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Let God arise. That's Psalm 64. And my enemies be scattered. Let God arise. And my enemies be scattered. Let God arise. And my enemies be scattered. Let God arise. Let God arise. And your enemies be scattered. Let every hidden enemy, that is hiding in your life, every hidden enemy, enemies of darkness, enemies that conceal their name, enemies that conceal their temper, that hiding behind the bushes, that are hiding behind the trees, that are hiding behind the mountains, that are hiding in the water of spirit, that are hiding behind the easy sea, and behind the rocks. Every enemy, oh Father God, Father God, oh let them come on by fire, come on by fire, come on by fire.
Power that's trying to hold me
have bound up and I put on your back. And I put them in the head. I do not say, roll about the stone. I want you to raise it, roll about the stone. He was dead for 3 days. That smell that strings are back on us. And Jesus said, Love us. Come forth. He come and raise up our paradise. Come forth. I come right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Name I pray. Hallelujah. 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 What is impossible for man is possible to God. All things are possible to God. Whatever you burn on earth is burning in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth is loose in heaven. Loose your whole thing. Loose your whole. Loose your power of darkness. You power of sickness and disease. You power of confusion and lies. Loose your whole. 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 Sickness and disease. Infirmity. I command. In the name of Jesus. That every organ in your body, from the throne of the head to the bottom of your soul, every organ, every chemistry, chemical, every blood cell, the function according to God's design, all of creation, people function, the God-given all of creation, people function, the creation of God, of the human body.
Jesus was beaten all night long. And by stripes we are healed. He
heal, divine healing, divine healing, divine order of creation, divine order of creation, divine order of creation, healing power of the blood, healing power of the blood, healing blood of Jesus, healing power of blood, healing power of the blood, healing power of the Lord. Oh, Father God, you say in your word, let there be light, and there was light. Hallelujah. Send your light, O Lord. Light of the world. Jesus Christ. Light of the world. Jesus Christ. Shine upon me. Shine upon us right now. Shine upon us. Shine upon us. Shine upon us. Heal us, Lord. Shine upon us, Lord. Shine upon us. Shine upon us. Deliver us from the power of darkness. Deliver us from the power of darkness. Deliver us from the power of darkness. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. I said, what is faith? The word of God says it's impossible to please God without faith. What is faith? Faith is to believe in the essence of the things not seen. Faith is the hope. The hope that the things that you believe will come to pass. Begin to have faith. Strengthen your faith, O Lord. I do not strengthen your faith. If you have faith, as part of a mustard seed, you will say to that evil situation, to your evil condition, to that circumstance, be thou removed in the name of Jesus. Sickness and disease, be thou removed in the name of Jesus. Confusion, be thou removed in the name of Jesus. Be thou removed. Begin to confess. Begin to confess. Believe in your heart. Believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. Be thou removed. Spirit of poverty, spirit of violence, spirit of domestic violence, spirit of criminology. Every evil disease that have your power. Spirit of confusion, spirit of confusion, spirit of confusion. Oh, be thou removed, be thou removed, be thou removed, be thou removed. Out of my life, Satan. Get out of my life, Satan. Get out of my life, poverty. Get out of my life, sickness and disease. I declare, according to Leviticus chapter 11, the helpful laws in the book of Genesis 1:26 through the end of that. Oh, yes, I declare in the name of Jesus, cleanse, everyone. Cleanse my body, cleanse my mind, cleanse my spirit, cleanse my soul, cleanse my children, cleanse my grandchildren, cleanse husband, cleanse my wife, cleanse Lord, cleanse me, wash me, O Lord, wash me with your blood, wash me by making water flow, wash me, purify me, wash me, O Lord, in Jesus' mighty name I pray. Hallelujah. 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 Blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, fight my battles. Oh, yes, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, fight my battles. Any power standing in my way, drop down and die. Any power standing in my way, drop down and die. The word of God says, suffer, wish not to live. I suffer a witch not to live. Any witchcraft, any witch standing in my way must drop and die. 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 Even witches, wizards, and voodoo priests and root workers, occultists, drop and die. Psychic hotline, drop and die. Drop and die. Drop and die. Jezebel spirit, drop and die. Drop and die. Any power standing in my way, drop down and die. Any power standing in my way, drop down and die. Blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, fight my battle. Blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, fight my battle. And hallelujah, Lord. Glory be to thy name, O Lord. Glory to Jesus, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for these prayer points. Thank you, Father, for strengthening our mind. Strength to give us strength, O Lord. Give us strength that we will know right from wrong. Give us strength. Give us strength, O Lord, that we will have better understanding of your word. Give us strength, Lord. Strength to overcome the wiles of the enemy. Strength to overcome the Antichrist. Strength to overcome in this beast system. Strength to overcome our enemies, our trials, our tribulations. Deliver us and give us strength. Give us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Hold on to Christ. Hold on to God. Don't let go. Oh, yes, Lord. Hold on to God. Don't believe what the majority says, because the majority sometimes is wrong. Hallelujah. We turn our good books to the book of Genesis. We're going back to the beginning. Lord, bless your word. Give them spiritual eyes to see. Give them spiritual ear to hear. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. And today we're going to continue in Genesis chapter 3. Genesis chapter 3. We see here in Genesis chapter 2, like Adam received the first commandment ever given to any man. It was given to the man Adam. At that commandment, Adam was warned, because there was a penalty in place, and that penalty was the curse of death. The curse of death. The soul that sins shall die, shall surely die. What is a spiritual death? When you are spiritually separated from God. You are alienated from God. You are far from God. So many Christians today believe that they are close to God because they go to church on Sundays and Bible studies on Wednesdays and Thursdays. So they believe because they attend to a church and they attend to a congregation that they are close to God. But many of them are going to be in a rude awakening because they are far away from God. The thing is that many are far off from God. They are far off from God because going to church is a ritual. They do not have a personal relationship with God the Father or the Son. They do not have the blessings of the Holy Spirit in their life. Everything that they do it in a carnal, mechanical way. They are unspiritual. They are unfaithful. They are they're broken and they need to be put together again. The book of John chapter 3 says, we must be born from above. You've got to receive the Holy Spirit. You must be born from above. Your spiritual eyes, your spiritual understanding. God wants you to know the truth. And the truth will set you free. And who the Lord sets free is free indeed. We have free will. The majority of the souls have free will. And a little rest of the soul are the elect. What are the elect? Who are the elect? Who are the holy Sabbath, the priesthood, the royal priesthood, those who stood against Satan, Lucifer, and the one third in the foundation of the earth and fought in the war against Satan. Christianity is a lifestyle, and being a Christian means like you are a warrior. You must learn to fight the spiritual fight. Christianity has been corrupted by Christian pagans. You can Google it. Christian pagans who included certain things in the Bible when they translated the Bible. They included the word Easter in the book of Acts chapter 12. They turned around and included the name of Jehovah. Jehovah is the moon god. Research it for yourself. study the book of Enoch, the book of Jubilee, the book of Asher, there's other books like the Apocrypha that the Roman Catholic Church removed over the King James Version because it did not want you to know the truth. If those books were left into the Bible, then you would have known. Even the book of Adam and Eve, there's a book that they removed. It's called, it was also put together by Moses, and also Jubilee, Enoch, all of those books, Joshua, was put in place by Moses when it was on Mount Sinai. It was dictated to him by God. And those books will prove to you that rapture is a lie. It will actually prove that rapture is a lie. So what the Catholic Church, since rapture came from the Catholic Church, they took those books out in order to keep you blind, to keep us blind. But I've been doing research for over 20 years because I was hurt, because of my soul was sore, and I knew there was something else. I said, this is too mechanical. Christianity has become a manja, like a big potato salad. It has metaphysical and esoteric and teachings and spirits in it. It has men tradition. They're always telling you to quote this man from the past, and who is this man? His name is not in the Bible. So everything has become a matter. Then they have doctrines of devils and demons. They have you calling an other names that is in the Bible that weren't supposed to be in the Bible. They're worshiping an angel, doctrines of devils and demons, ritualistic demonic worship in the church. They even lied to us and told us Adam and Eve ate an apple. But you will know today that serpent is the synonymous name of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And that tree of knowledge of good and evil is the old serpent from the garden. You can find all in some of his names in the book of Revelation chapter 12 will tell you who is the Antichrist. It is the same very picture that you have and you see your grandmother, everybody had on his wall. It is a picture of the angelical look with the beard and the piercing blue eyes and the white linen, like it says, say, this is the image of Jesus. That is nothing but Satan, the image of the beast, Revelation 12 will tell you. And we're going to study about Satan today. Who is Satan? The tree of knowledge of good and evil. Genesis 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any other beast of the sea, which the Lord God had made. Remember, beast, we connect to the beast system. Beast, creature, these are creatures. Like in Romans chapter 1, it talk about creatures. We are the creatures, flesh, angelical beings, animals, sea, creature. So this creature, this beast is called serpent. But who is serpent? Serpent is the cherub that covers it. From Isaiah 14 and Ezekiel 28, it is the archangel, like the serpent on the mercy seat on the left-hand side. His name was Lucifer. In the book of Jubilee, you will find his original name that it was given to him before he became evil. God did not create evil. God did not send evil in this world. God did not plan for us to live in the condition and the situation and the circumstance that we're living in. God did not create the beast system. The beast system was implanted and created by the serpent. It started in the first earth age before we became flesh. He drew one third with his tail, and that one third of soul is called billions of souls that Satan drew, that he brainwashed them into turning against who? Our Father and Jesus Christ, Son of God. So he was able to brainwash them. He was able to promise them power. He said, we take the kingdom, and because I got the key of the gates of hell, and I have the keys of death, we can go ahead and kill God. So he thought he would kill God and kill Jesus. He nailed Jesus to the cross. But he thought he could take it in the first earth age. So there was a war in heaven, and that war in heaven in the first earth age, they rebelled against God, and God kicked them out. God kicked them out. He kicked them out the kingdom.
He put them in bonds. In the book of Joel, in the book of Jude, in the book of Obadiah, you will see those satanic angels. When they left the estate that God gave them, an estate, he gave them place for abode, where they were easily brainwashed by Satan. And he came down in this second earth age. Are we going to study about it? The serpent was more subtle than any other one in the field. Satan is a synonymous name for serpent. Serpent is a serpent, is the same one, is the devil, is the same one. Same persona, synonymous name, different names for him, different titles. And he said unto the woman, yeah, had not God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? He using the word of God. Satan is a preacher. He's a pastor. He's a bishop. He called himself apostle. So Satan utilized the word of God to bring confusion among the children. So now he's using it. He's telling her. He's reading it backward. Yet at God said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. You see, that's not what God said. God didn't say that. God said here that in verse 16, and the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden may you eat freely. But Satan turned it around and said, yet God said you shall not eat of every tree in the garden. He turns it around. He twists the word of God around to Eve. And the woman said unto the serpent, unto the devil, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. She corrected him. The woman Eve, she was innocent and pure at that time, up to the point when she was talking to him. And remember what we said, eat. We are eating now. She was not supposed to have anything to do with that tree of good and knowledge and evil. She should not have anything to do with the serpent. The translators put serpent in there. They should have put the tree of good and knowledge and evil. But all things happening the way all God wanted to happen. It is our job to study that we may find ourselves approved by God, our workmen not put to shame. Many shall be put to shame when the Antichrist comes. And the Antichrist is soon to come at the sixth trumpet, at the sixth vial, and the sixth seal. But of the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, this is what it says here. This is what she responded. But of the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it. But then she added on, this is what the woman said, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. I want you to take turn when people add on to the word of God, when they take off or when they read it backwards, it creates confusion. Why would the woman respond and say that, but the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. That's not what God says. Go back and see what God says. In verse 17 of Genesis 2, but of the tree of the good of knowledge, the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in that day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. She said it, but she said, why would she say, why would she put in there fruit? The word fruit was put in there because it had something else to do. Something else was going on at that time. So when you go back to the Hebrew, you're going to find If you have a strong concordance, you're going to find that the word touch, neither shall ye touch it, lest you die. The word touch is actually the word naga. N-A-G-A. I want you to Google it. Or if you have a strong concordance, what is the meaning of the word naga? And that word naga is tied into the ancient Hebrew meme, sexual intercourse, to be completely and wholly seduced in sexual desire. Why would the meaning of that sexual desire and that sexual intercourse, the translators translated it, touch? Verse 4. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. You see, that's what they do in certain denominations in occultic. In every occultic, they use sex as a ritual. They have the angels, the fallen angels use sex. They call themselves incubus, succubus demons. Their spirit is roaming the earth. And even to this day, having sex with women in the spiritual realm. Every satanic cult, every hidden cult, I don't care if it's the Eastern Star, the Freemason, it has to have some sex rituals in it. It has to have some orgies in it. And it goes back to all of this that went on in the garden. So then he lied to the woman. You see, sin did not come through Eve, but sin came through the serpent. Who is the serpent? The devil himself is the serpent. Revelation 12:9. That old devil of the garden, it is. He is the same one. He is the one that you saw in the picture. He is the one that the last pope of Rome is going to pave the way for. You can go back to YouTube and put in Resurrecting Your Spirit Ministry and study the mark of the beast, the beast system, the image of the beast, and you will get the Bible references. Verse 5. This is the lie of the devil, another lie of the devil. He's the father of lies. He is the originator of sin. How did it originate sin? Sin started in the first earth age. When he drew one third, he drew billions of souls to worship him. That was worshiping him. He is the master of the orchestra. He is the music director. He is the one who wants them to worship him. He is not of the puppet. So he has to use demons and helpers. And right now he's utilizing the flesh, the people, and the lust of the eyes. And sex. Perversion. 5. It says, for God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened. And ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. That's why his name is the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And he said, he lied. He lied to the woman, telling her a lie, and she believed the lie. She was completely seduced, naga. She was induced into a sexual relationship. And you can Google the word naga. N-A-G-A. And the discussion that they have, that her eyes shall be open, and that she will be as a god, meaning like she will have equal power as God. And that's what they promise in the occult, because many occultics, many wizards, and many witches have been delivered through my ministry. Right here online, and YouTube and other web people have contacted me in reference for prayers, and they're being delivered from satanic possession and satanic indoctrination. And they have conveyed to me that these are the things that they use. Even in voodoo, they got to have sex with the voodoo priest. Then after that, they tell them, you will be a god. You are a god in the making. From Santeria to Brujeria to root working to everything is the same thing they teach. Egyptians, everything is the same thing that from the God, the evil originator is the devil, the serpent himself. Verse 6, this is what happened. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, what is the food? The knowledge. Your fruit, the Bible said, and ye shall know them by their fruits. What kind of fruit are you producing today? You are you a tree of righteousness? Are you a fruit of a dead fig tree? What is a dead fig tree? A dead fig tree is a fig tree that cannot produce a good fig. All the fig that they have on there is dead or bitter. Sour grapes. Sour apples. Everything is sour. There's no good, there's no God in there. There's no Holy Spirit in there. They pretend that they have the Holy Spirit and they don't have the Holy Spirit. They pretend that they are Christians. They're not Christians. They are walking religiosity. They're religious freaks, busybody women, blabbermouth men. I tell you what, today, the kingdom of God is not made of blah, blah, blah. All that satanic worship on the pulpit. All that psychology, that sociology, and that's what they call it, and what they call it, humanistic behavior. All that philosophy and no power to deliver, no power to heal the sick, no power to heal the dumb, no power to bring back the blind and make the blind see, no power to deliver, just blah, 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 and beg for money. And all they say, give $20, it will convert to 40. Blah, blah, blah. Lovers of themselves. Lovers of things. They want to sit in the upper room. They want to be called rabbi, pastor, bishop. They want respect. They have no power. No power to deliver your soul. They don't care about you. They work for Lucifer. And this is where the woman was taken into her own lust and her own desire to be God and her own desire to have equal power as God. She saw that it was good for food and that it was pleasant to the eyes. He was handsome. He was good looking. She was becoming sexually seduced and a tree to be desired to make one wise. The wisdom of evil, the wisdom of good. She took of the fruit thereof and she did eat. But guess what? Adam was a man with a living soul. He was different from the six-day creation. This man was not created. He was formed from the dust of the earth, and God breathed inside of him with the breath of life, and he became the living soul. He was a shepherd. He was a leader. He was supposed to be the pastor. But the wife gave unto her husband, and with her husband, with her, and he did eat. They committed the same sin. Holy seduce. Initiation into the kingdom of darkness. They both was initiated under Lucifer. They became part of the Luciferian doctrine with the induction of ritualistic sexual acts. And the eyes of them both were open. And they knew that they were naked. How comes you know that you're naked? And they saw fig leaves together and make themselves aprons. And if it happened in a fig grove, it did not happen in an apple patch. It happened in a fig grove. That's why we got the generation of the fig tree. That's why those trees who produce bitter, the Bible talks about bitter figs. Those children of darkness, children of the satanic kingdom, criminals, murderers, rapists, pedophilia, and drug dealing, they're part of the kingdom of darkness. Liars, witches, warlocks, psychics, all of those who live an alcoholic, drug addiction life, they're part of the kingdom of darkness. And why would they sew them aprons? They sold aprons to cover their sexual organs. The aprons that they use in Freemasonry, if you look good, the apron cover their sexual organs. There are certain countries that they have the girls wear aprons. Those aprons cover only the bottom part of the sexual organs. Verse 8. And they heard the voice of the Lord. God walking in the garden. In the cool of the day. And sometimes when you're angry, God said, don't let the sun go down. That's what my grandfather used to say. The Lord said, don't let the sun go down in your anger. Ask God for forgiveness when you get anger. It says here, he waited for the cool of the day because God was angry. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord amongst the trees of the garden. They went among the trees. Remember, the trees also are symbolic of human, of other angelical beings, of other personas. So they hid themselves. You are a tree. I am a tree. We are the tree of righteousness. So they hid themselves behind the tree. And the Lord God called Adam. He's going to call the man out first because he's a spiritual leader. He's going to call the man Adam and say unto him, where are thou? He's hiding. Can anybody hide from God? No. No one can hide. It don't matter where you go, you can't hide. You can run, but you can't hide from God. And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid. Fear is the spirit of Satan. Fear is of the devil. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. He was afraid. And he told him why. Because I was naked, and I hid myself. Sexual immorality, perversion, homosexuality, prostitution, stripping naked, pimping, pedophilia, rape, molestation, whatever you call it, orgies, swinging, all type of sexual perversion. And that's what is involved in every satanic santeria, everything, and every voodoo, everything include that. They got a time where they have to sleep with one another and have sex with one another. The men with the men, the women with the women, the women and the children. They gave up a couple years, 10 years ago, a young lady called me, they blocked their number. And she said, Pastor, all we want you to do is to pray for deliverance. The mother gave her up as an offering, as a sexual offering. These things are happening in the black churches. And if it's happening, we know it happened in the white church first. It's happening today. All around the different churches is happening. We're living in the last days. Verse 11. Have thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou should not eat? And the man said, the woman, she is easier to blame the other one. It's easier to blame someone else. Some husband commit adultery. And some wicked pastors will say, if you was doing what you were supposed to do with your husband, you got to be a whore in the bed and a holy woman when you're not in the bed. And if you was doing what you were supposed to do, your husband would not cheat on you. If you was doing what you were supposed to do, your wife wouldn't cheat on you. You're supposed to do this thing and please your wife and please. That's what they would say. These are wicked counselors. These are satanic counselors who call themselves pastors because they have a church and the steeple. And you can research the meaning of the steeple and the church. It's a worship of Nimrod penis. Every church that you see with a steeple is under the Catholic Church. Nimrod. That's who they worship, Nimrod. Old ancient Babylon giant. 30 feet in a year. That's who they worship, Sudanamis. They worship, those are the worship of the crystal pagan. Google these things for yourself. Research these things. They worship Nimrod. All of those are Freemasons, Shriners, and occultic churches. Come out from among them and be separate, say the Lord. Come out from among them. Come out. You cannot be friend with the world and say you love God. You're watching dirty videos and you say, hey, this is my favorite artist. You're still a lover of the world. You love the world. You love the entertainment world. Those are the image of the beast system. And the devil are using them to confound people and to be inducted into satanic worship of the Antichrist and the kingdom of darkness. And he said, woman, what is this that thou? He said, woman, that thou gave me of the tree, and I did eat. It's easier to do displacement and blame it on your parents and blame it on your wife and blame it on this and blame it. Blame it on your childhood. Blame it. Yes, they go and they do things and say, I was abused. I was mental abused. They go and they lie and they don't have no self-control. They are followers. They are not leaders. 13. And the Lord God said unto the woman, what is this that thou hast done? But the woman was more truthful than the man. And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And you can see the word beguile. Beguile means when you are violated sexually. You see, beguile. You know, back in the days, old folks used to talk and say, who beguiled this young virgin? Who deflowered her and got her pregnant? Tell us who did it. And when you look at the neighbor, that's how old folks used to talk. That's all slave talk from the Caribbean, from all the, from the Latinos, and from right here in this country, in the African American community. That's what all folks used to do. Who beguiled? And look at him. He watching the other woman. All he wants to do is to beguile her, but he got his wife at home. How can a man have his wife at home and he wants to be in the bed waiting for him and he wants to go into another woman's bed and lay down? How can you have your husband waiting for you at home in your own bed, but you going into another woman's husband's bed? I even as minister, one day there was a young lady on the phone. And she said, I want you to pray. That's 1997. I was praying with her. And while I was praying, I started praying in tongues. And I said, yes, you're pregnant. And the Lord said, that child that you have a calling on this, and don't commit the abortion. She said, you just don't know. And she hung up the phone. Then she called me and she said she did an abortion. And she has been miserable. She has never been happy. She has never been married or anything to this day. Then one day she was talking to me and I started praying in the spirit and I listened to her. And I kept on praying in the spirit and I kept on listening to her. And then she confessed. She was pregnant by her friend's husband. This is a woman who goes to church every Sunday. And she sat there and got pregnant by another woman's husband in the church. You see, that's why she couldn't have the child. She told me, you just don't know. You don't know. I couldn't have the baby. She was speaking about her selfish shame and her disgrace. These things happen in the church. 14. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, he's going to judge. God is going to call judgment against the enemy. Because thou hast done this, thou hast cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field, and upon thy belly thou shalt go, and thou shalt go eat all the days of thy life. And this is, let's go back in the Hebrew. This does not mean a snake crawling on the belly and that the snake had wings. The devil is a liar. The Luciferian doctrine, the Jehovah's Witness came from Russell. Russell was an Illuminati. He was a Luciferian. He started that. And out of the Luciferian church came two, Ellen G. White and the Seventh-day Adventists, Luciferians. They worshiped the sun up to sundown. Research these religions. Research the founder. Go back to the foundation of everything. And you find out the truth. God give us natural self-defense, spiritual self-defense inside of you. When people tell you something, when you hear something, say, no, I'm going to write this now. I got to find out the truth. That doth mean death. That's why we said doth to doth, ashes to ashes. That Satan has been judged and condemned to die into the pits of hell. And this is what the prophecy says. Between the seed of the woman and the seed of the serpent. And I will put an enmity between thee and the woman. Between the seed of the woman and the seed of serpent. And that seed. And between thy seed and her seed. What kind of seed are we talking about? Children. Progeny. Sons and daughters. Research the word seed. Out of seed that germinates, it grows a tree. Out of that tree must bear fruit. If you plant an apple tree, don't expect pineapples to grow on it. Because an apple tree can never produce apples and bananas. And a mango tree cannot produce a watermelon. So let us keep in mind, and we must do research. Out of a seed, it grows something. So when he said, I will put enmity between that seed and your seed, it's talking about children, the children that are coming forth. Something happened, some type of conception, something seed is going to come forth, and it shall bruise the head. The seed of the woman is going to bruise the head of the serpent, all the children of the serpent. And those shall bruise his heel. And that's the heel of Jesus Christ that was nailed to the cross. Because when we went back in research, and you can research all the way from Eve, from generation to generation, and it's going to bring forth a generation to bring forth the birth of Jesus. So Eve is the great, 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 great ancestor of Jesus' mother, Mary. Because of that amniotic fluid, because of the DNA of the Levitical. See, Mary's mother was a Levite and her father was a Judite. So you have two seeds in one. You got the Levitical priesthood and the Judah, which is the kingship and the princess and the queens. So you got the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You have the Levite and you have the Judah and Levite coming together in the seed of Mary. That's why we say King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Unto the woman, see, Christ is going to come. Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow in conception. In sorrow, thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be thine husband, and he shall rule over thee. And curses come. Anytime you sin, anytime we fall into sin, curses come. Curses can be passed down from one generation to the other generation. The seed of the serpent is active today. 13 families which have the bloodline of Satan, the serpent in the garden. That's why we have the back of the dollar bill has the triangle going up with 13 steps. Research it for yourself. 17, to close out, we're going to continue tomorrow. 17, and unto Hanan he said, more curses coming, because thou hast hearkened to the voice of thy wife. Sometimes we cannot hearken to the voice of our husbands. Sometimes we cannot hearken to the voice of evil. Sometimes, husband, you cannot hearken to the voice of your wife. Job's wife told him to curse God. To curse God and die. You cannot hearken to the voice of your wicked wife. You cannot hearken to the voice of your wicked husband or your wicked fiancé. And God's eaten of the tree, which I commanded thee, saying, thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for thy sake. And why God cursed the ground? Because Adam was created to be a planter, a farmer, a person who tilled the ground. Go back all the way back to chapter 2. There was no man to till the ground. So he cursed the ground. He cursed the ground physically. He cursed the ground. Adam was cursed on that day. And it say, in sorrow shall thou eat of all the days of our life. Thorns and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. And in thy sweat of thy face thou shalt eat bread till thou return unto the ground. All of it was thou taken, for dust thou art, and to dust thou shalt return. And the same thing he did to the serpent. Dust. That's why when we have a funeral, we say dust to dust, ashes to ashes, praise be to God, with the return absent from the body, present with the Lord. We must understand that God is a spirit. And God is a forgiving God. And that Adam and Eve sinned along with this devil. The serpent is the tree of knowledge of good and evil. You can Google it for yourself. Who is the tree of knowledge of good and evil? Google it. Google, start researching for yourself. Don't believe things that you hear. Some people you hear, some people see that many of them who gone out in the world saying that Jesus, but everybody who say Jesus don't mean that they love Jesus. Satan is a scripture lawyer. He's a Bible lawyer. He's a bishop. He's a preacher. He loves prayer lines. There's prayer lines that say a lot of lies. But I'm giving you the word, and I'm giving you the word of understanding, and now it's your responsibility, once you receive the word, to go back and research it for yourself. So finally, Adam started obeying God. In verse 20, this is the first time. He named all the cattle, but he didn't have no time for his wife. Because he was a workaholic. Men and women of God are supposed to learn to spend time with their husbands and their wives and their children. Mothers to do activities with their children. Parents supposed to do activities and things together as a family. Family comes from God. God put families together. God uses family. God is the creator of marriage. God is the creator of sex. He told them in Genesis 1:26-27, when he created them in 28, he blessed them. He did a mass wedding, and he said he gave them the womb, be fruitful and multiply. Come on, be fruitful. Be fruitful. Come on, the fruit of the body. What is the fruit of your body? The fruit of my body is my children, my grandchildren. You begot. Come on, be fruitful. The same thing that Satan and the serpent and the woman discuss about fruit. What are you eating today? Has God prepared a table for you in the presence of your enemies? I urge you today to hold on to God. Because it says here he started obeying God. And Adam called his wife named Eve because she was the mother of all living. When it says mother of all living, mother of all of those who have the Holy Spirit. And unto Adam is also, and unto his wife did the Lord God make coats of skin and clothed them. You see that covering. God covered their body. They couldn't be naked anymore because all the innocence was gone. They were deflowered on the same day. They took part in an orgy, in a sexual promiscuity, in a sexual violation in the presence of God in the garden. And Google it for yourself. And the Lord God said, or if you have a strong concordance, you can look it up. And the Lord God said, behold, the man has become as one of us. He has become as one of us. That's what God said. Once this took place, once they paid his sin, once a child has been violated, once a young girl loses her virginity, she's been raped, she's been induced, and she thinks she fell in love, you will never be the same. Once they do drugs, evil spirit come into their body. Marijuana is a gateway. Now they're doing bad stuff and doing cannibalism. Once you lose your innocence, you become different. There's something about you has changed. Parents can see it in their teenage children. Something different about you. You're rude. You're cocky now. You're answering back now. You grow now. You're smelling your bottom lip now. That's what old folks say. You suck in your tongue. They slap you in your face. Your uncle come in and say, oh, I heard you was rude to grandmama. Bam, bam, bam. Your auntie come in. You disrespect your grandmama. Everybody start beating you. It said the man has become as one of us to know good and evil. And now, lest he put his hand and take off also of the tree of life and eat and live forever. See, the tree of life is the mercy one. Whose name is mercy? His name is Jesus, Yeshua, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Kings, of the Lord of Lords. If they eat from him, they will live eternally. They will not die in the flesh. They will not taste death. But then there is either being open to evil and to good. He can think evil. He can look evil. They can be deceived. Children are accountable only when they begin to know what is right from right. Wrong. The age of accountability is between 12 and 13. If the child has mental disability, they're never going to be accountable. They cannot be accountable because mentally disabled children and men or women do not know what is right from wrong. They are special souls that God sent down here. We must aid and protect children always. It's better a millstone to be wrapped around the neck than you touch any of these little ones. Even the little ones like me and you, we are God's little ones. We are little children. Paul referred to us as little children. Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he came from, to plant and grow his corn and rice, whatever. So he drove them out, and he placed at the east of the garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword which turned every way to keep the way from the tree of life. Google. The tree of life is also mentioned in the book of Revelation. The tree of life is in the book of Enoch, the book of Jubilee, the book of Jasher, the Apocrypha. Those things are very important for you to learn and study. You can go on the YouTube, and there is a young man who has a nice, young Hebrew Jewish guy who have a nice, all them books and compile. So you, when you go, you put Book of Enoch, and you will see where it says 3 hours. The Book of Jubilee, J-U-B-I-L-L-L-E-E. You can go and see the Book of Adam and Eve that they took out of Genesis. There was a book called the Book of Adam and Eve. You can listen to it per verbatim. Father God, in the name of Jesus, open up the eyes of your children. Give them spiritual eyes. Let your light shine upon them. Warm them with the Holy Spirit, O Lord Father. Keep them clothing in your Holy Spirit. Bread of heaven, feed your children. Feed us, Lord, till we want no more. Oh, Father God, prepare a table for us in the presence of the enemy. We are sitting in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Right now, Father God, bless them right now. Each and every one in Jesus' mighty name. As we continue this book of Genesis this week, in order for you to get your spiritual understanding, you must study that you may find yourself approved. Because if you learn the foundation, that way things were set up for the devil, you will understand why we have rapists, murderers, why we paying bills, why we working 9 to 5, why the church is so corrupt and wicked, why these things are happening, why women fight, why women prostitute their body. It is some wickedness that happened on the face of this earth. And God is given us free will, and because of our free will, God, we must choose this day who we will serve. We will serve the King of Darkness or the King of Light. Choose this day. Study. Research. Seek God. Pray about these things. But don't knock it. Don't look at the messenger. Look at the message that the messenger is being sent to you. This is the end times. We have at least 3 more years. Before the world war break out, the Antichrist will manifest in power. He's going to be buying cars and paying homes and giving money to people, and they're going to bow down and worship him. But I tell you, he's the devil himself. He is not born from a woman. But he is Satan getting ready to be cast out. He have a forerunner just like John the Baptist. It's called the last pope, the Petrus Romanus. The Escario Filideos, that's what he claimed in Latin. He claimed that he is the all-knowing, all-power, all-seeing, but I said the devil is a liar. You can study Isaiah 14, Ezekiel 28, Revelation 12. Be blessed and be encouraged. And remember, defeat Satan in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. You can find these biblical studies and warfare prayers on YouTube. Just put in Resurrecting Your Spirit Ministry. You'll see my picture, my face, you know, the older picture. I'm a little older now, but God bless you, God. Keep you, God. Encourage you in Jesus' mighty name. Father God, bless them coming in. Bless them coming out till we meet again. Let the love of God and the protection of the Holy Spirit cover you and protect you all the way in Jesus' mighty name. I pray, amen. Be blessed, be encouraged, and remember Luke chapter 10:19. Behold, I give you power over all. He gave us power over principalities, powers, the enemies, everything, including the devil himself. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. Defeat Satan. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.